Welcome to the Winter Universiad Krasnoyarsk 2019 and day four of the Alpine program at the ski resort fun park Bobrovolok for what is going to be the third day of action for the women. And we turn our attention to the more technical disciplines. It is women's giant slalom day, run one, coming up for you now. Well, it is a glorious day here at the Fun Park Bobrovolok, and the athletes going through their warm-up ahead of what is a very tough and testing giant slalom track. The temperature, well, just below freezing as it has been throughout, not cold enough to keep the woodpeckers at home. The wildlife waking up after a harsh winter. And we're looking forward to some really spectacular racing in this giant slalom. There is the track, 43 gates, only two double gates, so 41 turning gates on what is a steep and icy and very narrow track. And it is going to test these athletes to the very limit to try and get down. As always with giant slalom, it's the combined time of two runs. The fastest 30 from the first run going in reverse order in the second run. And the top 15 seeds drawn at random in the top 15 positions. And from 16 downwards, it goes on the FIS points order. So Plezovnik at 16, the best of the rest, as it were, outside the top 15. But in total, we have a massive 79 racers from 27 countries taking part. The first of the Russians, Anastasia Gonostayeva, 19 years of age, who raced slalom at the World Championships last month in order. Four top threes in giant slalom, two wins, the last of which was in March 2018 in the Russian National Championships. And she is very late in the line. Has to adjust quickly. What does the clock say? The clock says she's half a second the wrong side of our leading time of Macheret. Now, Gonostayeva. Can she get it back together on this middle section? Nishijima found a third of a second through this section of the challenge. Gonostayeva, she looks quick. No snow coming off the edges of her skis, and she is quick because she's found a bucket load of time. She's found 0.8 seconds in that middle section. Gonostayeva skiing like a possessed athlete for the line, looking to take it away. Can she break the minute mark? No, she can't, but she goes first, 0.62. What a bottom two-thirds of the run for Gonostayeva. Sofia Konkina of Russia, the next to go. Konkina, 21 years of age. She would have had a lot of time, you think, on this hill, and she is half a second the right side of Gonostayeva. That is a fantastic couple of turns coming onto the steep section from Konkina. Now, can she continue this good form? Brilliant carved turns here from Konkina. This is going to be very quick if she can keep it together through this steeper section. It's going to flatten out now. And the time split tells us that she's 0.48 the right side of the clock. Konkina has matched Gonostayeva through that middle section, and she was quicker on the top. Konkina surely going to take it away. We might even have the minute mark broken here. Touch for the line. Oh, she's lost it on the bottom turns. Will you believe it? She's lost over half a second. Goes into second, 0.08, the wrong side of the clock. Bib number 8 is Yulia Pleshkova of the Russian Federation. 21 years of age, made her World Cup debut in downhill this season on the women's tour in Kromontana. Came 26th, didn't race the speed events here. What can she do here? She is an all-rounder. She won an FIS giant slalom race in Krasnoyarsk on this hill last year, which was her first and only podium in giant slalom. And she's very much in touch with Gonostayeva. But Gonostayeva was incredibly quick through this section. This is where Pleskova has got to let the skis run. She's got to get early in the turn, and she's very early in the turn. It's nice, but is it quick? That is the question. 44-64, the next time split, and Pleskova looks quick. Then she's 800ths off the pace, but can she find the time on these bottom turns? Pleskova trying to take it away from our leader, Gonastayeva, in that tuck position, trying to accelerate out the turns, build speed out of the turns, and she breaks the minute mark. 0.22, that is how to ski the bottom section, putting pressure on the inside edge, letting the release of the ski drive you forward, and Pleskova with an excellent run, and Russia block out the podium. Lia Chapuis of France, the next to race, 21 years of age, 10 podiums in giant slalom in FIS races to this season, a second and third on consecutive days in the French ski resort of Merida. How is she faring at the top here? And she is quick, Chapuis. Nearly half a second the right side of the clock, but this is the difficult part of the challenge, and she looks a little unsettled at the top of the steep. Better now from Chapuis as she gets the turn in before the gate, sets herself up for the next one as a result of getting the early turn in, but is she inside 44.72? That's the question. She is by a quarter of a second. Now the French athlete has to drive here. Pleskova was really driving the skis through these turns, accelerating out of them. Has Chapuis done the same? Can she get inside 59.94? Chapuis, two from home, it looks too slow. She didn't drive the skis in those turns. It was too passive, and that is why she lost the time. Bib number 17, Ekaterina Takachenko from the Russian Federation. 11 giant slalom podiums in her career. Her last came in March of 2018. Now the Russians have been skiing this absolutely beautifully, and you'd expect no different from Takachenko, who would have had plenty of feedback from her coaches and teammates on the radio. And she is 54 hundredths, the right side of the clock. But Pleskova, our leader, was so impressive on the bottom. Just to give you an idea of how well she skied the bottom, Pleskova, she was the 13th quickest at the first intermediate, and she was first at the bottom. She flew down this section, and Takachenko is trying to keep pace with her. And Takachenko, the time split hasn't come up on our clock, so this is going to be interesting, but 59.94 is the time for Takachenko to beat. And we don't know if she's beaten it or not. We'll have to wait and see when that comes up on our screens. And it's been confirmed, Takachenko is the fastest with a time of 59.44. That's half a second quicker than Pleskova. Lada Zvecha of Switzerland, the next to go. Fourth at the National Junior Championships in February this year. What can the Swift athlete do here? Nice opening turns. And she's 0.44, the right side of the clock. The timing's not quite right. Well, 0.44 on our screens, 0.1 on our computer screen here in the commentary box. And Zvecha, 0.8 of a second off the clock. And the second split goes into 4.41, so find some time. Bib number 30, Amélie Dupakier, the silver medalist in the Super G and the Alpine combined. What can she do in the GS? And that was a big skidded left-footed turn on that red gate. 19 years of age. Might just fancy her chances on the slalom. 20.72 is 0.36 faster, or slower, sorry, I should say, than our leader. And these are nice turns from Dupakier, who's into the rhythm of the course. 45.2, good enough for 12th at the moment. Driving for the line, and she goes 6.58 of a second off the pace. Good work from Dupakier. So here are the official results from the women's giant slalom first round. Ekaterina Takachenko taking the lead, 59.44. Half a second quicker than Pleshkova. Gonostayeva in third with Krokina in fourth. The Russian Federation looking good for the second run. Remember, the fastest 30 from the first run go in reverse order at the start of the second run. So as we turn the page here, we will see that the first athlete out the gate in the second run will be Veronika Chamkova of the Czech Republic. Second run of women's giant slalom coming your way, and the Russian Federation in pole position to claim their first medals of the Alpine program. And that is the view from the top of the mountain. And the fastest 30, so Veronika Chamkova, 30th fastest after the first run, she will go first. And the quickest of the all from the first run, Ekaterina Takachenko of the Russian Federation, will go 30th and last of the top 30. And as you can see, Krokina, Gornostayeva and Pleshkova all lining up. So the Russian Federation in an excellent position to try and, as I say, win their first medals of this Alpine program. Lia Chapuis of France waits to challenge. Eighth quickest after the first run. Her advantage, 13 hundredths of a second over Smoldore of Italy, who leads the way after the combined time of her two runs. Chapuis. Good turns. And the clock says she's 16 hundredths the wrong side. Chapuis trying to keep the rhythm of the pattern of gates. Oh, then gets her left hand caught in the gate, but manages to maintain her balance. It's very easy to go down, 0.15. She's got 1/100 of a second back. Chapuis needs to drive these turns, try and create speed if she can to take the gold away from Smoldore. Smoldore's time, 2:00.12. She finds time, but not enough, and is second by 7/100. A penultimate challenger, as I say, from Switzerland, Amélie Dupakier, a two-time medalist in these games from Super G and Alpine combined. Silver in both of those. What can she pull out the hat here? Secured her best giant slalom result this season on the FIS Tour when she came fifth. And she is more of a slalom skier than a GS skier, so she'll be around in the final event, or the final individual event for the women. Dupakier looks unlikely to enter her medal pool in the giant slalom. 1:43.8, and she's nearly a second off the pace of Smoldore. Switzerland will have one more chance unless Dupakier can really drive these bottom turns. Drives for the line, third, 0.12. She finds 0.8 of a second on the bottom. That is the most we've seen by anybody. Bib 38, Denise Dingsleder from Austria, 0.36 of a second, her advantage over Petra Smoldore. And here comes the Austrian now. 21 years of age, has four Europa Cup starts under her belt. The level just below the World Tour. And Dingsleder is 0.39 the right side of the clock. She's increased her lead by 3/100ths of a second. Driving those turns, and is it enough to maintain the green light? The second split, 143.8. Bing Sleder does have the green light by 1/15ths of a second. This is going to be tight. Can Bing Sleder find time on these bottom turns? She's looking aggressive, trying to build speed by pressurizing the outside ski, and she breaks 2 minutes, and that is great skiing on the bottom. And she takes over the lead. Lara Zürcher of Switzerland, the last of the Swiss. And off she goes with a small advantage of 5/100ths of a second. Trying to chase down Denise Bing Sleder of Austria. Austria, who've won the first two gold medals of the ladies competition. That's a great turn from Zürcher coming over the terrain change. She's got that blind gate spot on. Will it benefit her on the bottom section? She looked a little late in the line off that right-footed blue gate. Big plume of snow from the white ski. Now 143.65, and she is nearly 3/4 of a second the wrong side of the clock, but can she drive these bottom turns? Zürcher, Switzerland trying to take it away from Austria, the biggest of rivals when it comes to alpine skiing. And she stops the clock and goes fifth, 1.12 off the pace. Not going to be Switzerland's day today. The top three, the fastest three from the first run, remain at the top of the hill. And the third quickest after the first run is this lady here, Anastasia Gonostayeva, 0.24 of a second quicker than Denise Bing Sleder after the first run. Gonostayeva, who was unbelievable on the bottom half of the track in the first run. She was the 13th quickest at the first time split in run one, and ended up coming third. So she can ski those flat turns, but she's lost nearly all of that advantage. Just 2/100ths of a second the right side of the clock. She's gonna have to go here, Gonostayeva. She can afford no more mistakes. She needs to keep these turns clean. She's getting on that outside ski just about in time. 143.65, the second time split, and she is in touch, 0.08. This is where she was so good in the first run. Can she repeat the feat here and take the gold away from Bing Sleder? Gonostayeva to give the Russian Federation their first medal if she can get in front of the Austrian. She can't. 0.34 the wrong side of the clock. Julia Pleshkova, bib number 8 from the Russian Federation, second quickest after the first run. Her advantage over Bing Sleder of Austria, 0.46 of a second. Pleshkova, 21 years of age, made her World Cup debut this season, but in the speed event of downhill and Crans-Montana. And her advantage, 0.46, is down to just 0.07ths at the first time split. And a little twist of the upper body as she comes onto the steep section. Pleshkova, who, like Gonostayeva just before, was so quick on the second half of the run, needs more of the same here. 143.65, the next time split for Pleshkova. Pleshkova, here she comes, and she's still got the green light, 0.09ths of a second, the right side of the clock, for the athlete from the Russian Federation. Pleshkova to take gold away from Bing Sleder of Austria. She's driving these bottom turns. These look powerful turns, but is it good enough? No! 0.07, the wrong side of the clock. Well, she knows she's got a medal. Ekaterina Tkachenko from the Russian Federation, the quickest athlete in the first run. Her advantage over Denise Bing Sleder of Austria, our current leader, a massive 0.96 of a second. Tkachenko was unbelievable in the first run, especially on the second half, and she is flying on the top here. Tkachenko, 0.96 the right side of the clock. It's down to 3/4ths of a second. Needs to keep this clean if she can. Catalina Takachenko, 11 Grand Slam GS podiums in her career. The last came in March of 2018, but these look good turned. Are they good enough? 1:43.65. Ding Sledder's next split time. And she is the right side of the clock by 1.42 seconds. Takachenko destroying the second run, accelerating away in these bottom turns. Surely she's going to take gold away from Ding Sledder and deliver for the Russian Federation. She's home by 0.87. Takachenko is the champion. And the Russian Federation have their first gold of the Alpine program. Disappointment for Gunnarsdayeva as she is bumped off the podium. But Russia have a gold medal and it goes to Ekaterina Takachenko and her teammates are the first to congratulate her. Her first win in a giant slalom race since February 2015. What a time to deliver on home snow. The final result then of the women's giant slalom after two runs. Ekaterina Takachenko of the Russian Federation takes gold, 1:58.52, 0.87 quicker than Denise Ding Sledder of Austria, who picks up the silver. And Yulia Pleshkova from the Russian Federation picks up the bronze. So two medals for the host nation. Their first of the Alpine program have been delivered in the women's giant slalom. So it's time for the flower presentation ceremony.
Russian Federation, first place, representing Russian Federation, Ekaterina Takachenko.
Ekaterina Takachenko taking the gold medal. A brilliant performance by her. Quickest in the first run, second quickest by only 9/100ths in the second. A deserved champion in the women's giant slalom here at Fun Park Poplovlog.
Дорогие друзья, поаплодируем нашим спортсменкам.
The Russian Federation's first gold in the Alpine program goes to Ekaterina Takachenko. Well, the Russian Federation had to wait until day four of the Alpine program before they won their first medals, and they've won two, a gold and a bronze. Austria with the silver. And a fantastic performance from Ekaterina Takachenko. Thanks for your company today from Funpark Poplovlog. And it's Russia who are celebrating with gold and bronze.